Hello friends, my name is Ksenia and we are learning Russian. At the moment we learn Russian nouns, cases of Russian nouns. And now we are choosing a case. We have six cases of nouns in Russian language. A case to use for a long course of 100 Russian nouns. So I read your suggestions and some students suggest to learn genitive case. We tried previous lesson, accusative case also was recommended, and today let's try this case. You will see if you like it or not, or if you need it or not to learn so precise, so detailed. We use accusative case when a noun is an object of an action, when we do something to it, when we see it, when we try it, when we touch it, when we buy it. So I think it's quite often used in everyday speech. And also, why Russian cases of Russian nouns and Russian grammar at all? Why all this is so complicated? Because in different cases Russian nouns have different endings, and even different nouns have different endings. For example, we have three declensions of nouns, and each declension has different endings in different cases. So three declensions, six cases, all this. Can you imagine? So if you will learn these nouns, you will have such huge tables, so you will go crazy. So that's why I recommend we just choose 100 Russian nouns, the most useful, and repeat them, and after this you will start feeling endings. So today, accusative case. Well, today, before I didn't explain declensions, today I will do this. We have three declensions. First declension, nouns with endings -aya in Russian language, -aya, first declensions. So, for example, car, a car, машина, ending -r, first declension, машина, an apartment, квартира, -a, ending -a, машина, квартира, a dog, собака, собака, машина, квартира, собака. All these nouns are in first declension, and so they will have the same endings in different cases, in any other cases. For example, let's take a verb to buy. With this verb we use nouns in accusative case because they are object of an action. We buy them, we buy this, we buy this, we buy this. An object of an action, accusative case. So, for example, I buy a car, машина, я покупаю машину, ending -у. In accusative case, машина, я покупаю машину. An apartment, квартира, я покупаю квартиру. A dog, собака, я покупаю собаку. Покупаю машину, покупаю квартиру, покупаю собаку. It's first declension. And second declension, nouns that ends with a consonant sound, and also nouns with endings o-ye. For example, a phone, телефон, consonant, no vowel in the, at the end, телефон, подарок, present, подарок, подарок, телефон, or wine, вино, ending o, телефон, подарок, вино. All these nouns are at second declension, and today we learn accusative case. In accusative case, these nouns don't change. Only in accusative case, only nouns of second declension. For example, телефон, I buy a phone, я покупаю телефон. Present, подарок, я покупаю подарок. Don't change. Wine, вино, я покупаю вино. So maybe that's why accusative case is easy. And also let's take third declension. In third declension we have nouns of feminine gender that ends with soft sign, like ночь, night, дочь, daughter, or other, but only feminine gender. So these nouns also don't change their endings in accusative case. So you see, accusative case is easy. For example, tissue, ткань, tissue, when you want to sell something. Я покупаю ткань. Ткань. Nominative case. Я покупаю ткань. Accusative case. The same form. A bed. Bed. Кровать. I mean, where you sleep. A bed. Кровать. Я покупаю кровать. The same. No change. So, you see, accusative case is easy. Only nouns that ends with a, я, change endings. So, maybe we will not, we don't need to learn it so detailed, because it's easy. So, if you want to say that you do something to something, you change ending only if a noun ends with a, я. What can you do? For example, you may see, I see, я вижу машину, я вижу квартиру, я вижу собаку, собака, вижу собаку, машина, вижу машину, квартира, вижу квартиру. Or when you take a picture, take a photo of, фотографирую, я фотографирую машину, фотографирую собаку. For example, I touch, я трогаю, for example, tissue, to touch if it's soft or not. Я трогаю ткань, we don't change, я трогаю ткань, я трогаю собаку, a dog. Я трогаю собаку if it's wet or dry. You may smell, я нюхаю wine, for example, я нюхаю вино, нюхаю вино. So you change ending only if a noun ends with a, машина, квартира, собака, мама, вижу маму, женщина, вижу женщину, what else, just вот это, рука, поднимаю руку, рука. Поднимаю руку, нога, поднимаю ногу. And now let's... Okay, today it's easy. Okay, let's have a little training as we usually do. Let's just... I say English, English phrase and you say Russian, okay? I say I buy a car, you say я покупаю машину, okay? So, I buy a car. Я покупаю машину. I buy an apartment. Я покупаю квартиру. I buy a dog. Я покупаю собаку. I buy a phone. Telephone. Я покупаю телефон. I buy a present. Я покупаю подарок. I buy wine. Я покупаю вино. I buy a tissue. Я покупаю ткань. I buy a bed. Я покупаю кровать. Молодец. Today is easy. To be honest, even I am happy that today is easy lesson. So write your suggestions about nouns. Which nouns you want to learn? Because you will use it in everyday speech. We will learn them in some other cases, and you will know endings. So follow my channel. Also join our Facebook page, see my next lessons. Let's learn Russian and make friends. Давайте учить русский, дружить. Пока!